In this screencast, we're going to look at a problem in which we're determining the power that's added by a pump to a fluid to move it from one location to another. Specifically, this is a problem that is dealing with calculating a certain pressure or losses and using the Moody chart to determine frictional factors and using this in our problem. We have a ski resort that needs to pump water at a certain temperature through 1,000 feet of 2-inch diameter steel pipe. This is from one location to another, and we're given those elevations. And we're told that the volumetric flow rate has to be a certain rate and that the pressure into the snow blowing machine has to have a certain pressure. We're also given information as to components of this piping system that are going to contribute to the losses. So try to set this up on your own and solve. With any problem like this, the first place to start is by drawing a diagram. We're going to draw our hill and our water reservoir down here. Then we're going to draw our piping system that comes from the water reservoir into some kind of pump, comes out of our pump and goes to our snow blowing machine. We're also told that there is a valve at the entrance to the system and that there are two 90 degree bends. So at this point, now that we have a diagram, it's important to label the points that we're interested in for this calculation. At the entrance of our piping system, which we'll call point one, and at the exit of our piping system into the machine, and I'll designate this as point two. We know that this is open to atmosphere, and we know that the pressure into the snow blowing machine has to be 20 psi. Now, it's probably safe to assume that that's going to be a gauge pressure. We're told that the volumetric flow rate, Q, has to be 0.25 feet cubed per second. We could say that there are two 90 degree bends, and make sure that we have those. We also know that this is a steel system. We also know that the entire length of this is 1,000 feet, and that our elevation change is 800 feet, which leads us into the second part of problem solving, is to write down what we want. So we want the horsepower for our pump. And with any experience of problems like this, we know that that means we're going to need delta P for the system and energy losses. Now we could look up power for a pump, and we could see that that's going to be equal to our shaft head for the pump, the specific weight of the fluid we're moving, and the volumetric flow rate. So we could already see that we're given two pieces of that information there, and we just need to find out the shaft work. So the approach we're going to take with this problem is an energy balance. So we could start by writing our general energy balance for a problem like this, which looks very familiar to something you might have seen before, the Bernoulli balance. But in this case, we've added two new terms. One, the shaft head, which is related to the power that we're either taking away or putting into the system mechanically, as well as the head loss, which are losses due to the piping system or the components. And as a refresher of the terms, P is the pressure. We have our specific weight on the bottom in the numerator. Our V is our velocity of the fluid at those points. G is the gravitational constant. Z represents its height with respect to whatever reference we're using. So we have our energy balance. And we know we need to figure out what the head loss is. So head loss is going to be written out as related to a frictional factor times the length of the system over the diameter of the system multiplied by a kinetic component. So you can see here that we could calculate the velocity based on our volumetric flow rate and our pipe diameter. We're given the length and the pipe diameter, so all we would need is the frictional factor. The frictional factor is going to be dependent on whether or not the flow is turbulent or laminar. We need to use the dimensionless term, the Reynolds number. Now the Reynolds number is a relationship of the inertial forces, which can be written as rho Vd, over the viscous forces. And so we use viscosity. Or we could rewrite this as the velocity times the diameter over the kinematic viscosity. And the kinematic viscosity for water at 10 degrees Celsius is 2.026 times 10 to the minus 3rd inches squared per second. The velocity of our fluid can be calculated as the volumetric flow rate over our cross-sectional area. When we do this calculation, we get a velocity of 11.5 feet per second. So now we have our velocity, we have our kinematic viscosity. We could calculate our Reynolds number by plugging in all the information that we have. When I calculate this out, I get Reynolds number of 1.4 times 10 to the fifth, which is greater than our standard 2100 for our transition from laminar to turbulent flow. We could safely say that this flow is turbulent. Where does that help us? Well, we're going to take this information and go to what's called a Moody chart to help relate a frictional factor to our flow in our pipe system. Here's our Moody chart. It's a logarithmic plot where we can see on the left side, y-axis, we have our frictional factor. On the bottom, we have our Reynolds number. And on the right, we have what's called a relative roughness, which is a relationship between the roughness of the pipe to the diameter of the pipe. And this is important because, as you recall, we're looking for our head loss term, which has our frictional factor within it. So let's go to the plot. We know we have a Reynolds number of 1.4 times 10 to the fifth. That puts us roughly right in this area. We would still need our relative roughness to do this calculation, so we pull that information up from a source. And we are told that we have commercial steel. And since we're working with feet as our units, our roughness is 0.00015, since it's 10 to the minus third. We take that and divide it by our diameter, and we get a relative roughness of approximately 9 times 10 to the minus 4. So we take that information, and we go up here to the axis on the right side, and we look for where 9 times 10 to the minus 4 would be. And that squeezes us in right here on the right side. So we would follow right between these two lines, and we would go over to where our Reynolds number is. I'm going to squeeze right inside both of them, and we'll move up until we get to right about where we want to. So let's say it's right here. Obviously, there's error with reading a Moody chart, but for the most part, you can see that on the left side, the frictional factors won't be too dramatic. So we're going to follow this line over somewhere about there, and say that that's about 0.021. So now we have our frictional factor. So let's go back to our main equation and rewrite it in the form that we're most interested in. We know if we use gauge pressure that P1 is equal to 0 since it's open atmosphere. We also know that the velocity at point 1 is also going to be 0, assuming that the height of the lake velocity is irrelevant compared to the velocity in the pipe. So knowing that information, we could rewrite our equation as the following. And we could do this on the right side because we know our head loss term was the friction factor times the length over the diameter in our kinetic term. So when we mix this together with our kinetic term, we get the following. So at this point, it's just an exercise in plug and chug. So I'll plug in our values into this equation so that you can see it. And you can see when I plug in all these numbers, I end up getting about 1,100 feet as our pump head that we would need to add by the pump. However, we've only calculated that of the major losses in the system, and we totally neglected the minor losses. Now, is that an appropriate thing to do in this case? Well, let's take a quick look at the minor losses and see how they stack up to the major losses. So when we look at the minor losses of a system, it's going to be the summation of all the losses due to the components. So you could look these values up and they're reported differently, but at least in our case, we're going to use a loss coefficient and multiply it by a kinetic component. So our loss coefficient for our valve, assuming that it's fully opened, would be 0.05. Our two 90-degree bends each have a loss somewhere between 0.2 and 1.5, depending on the type of elbow that it is. It could be flanged or threaded. So let's just assume somewhere in the middle that it'll have a KL ratio of 1, so that two of these would equal a KL of 2. So our minor losses due to the valve as well as the bends would be 2.05 times our kinetic variable. And you can see that this comes out to a very small number with respect to the major losses. Now we could account for this just to be more accurate. So our total shaft head that's necessary from the pump is going to be about 1111 feet. Now we take this and we put this into our equation for power, which shows that we would need the shaft head multiplied by the specific weight of the fluid and the volumetric flow rate gives us a value of 1.7 times 10 to the fourth pound foot per second. So we could convert this to horsepower and we could see that our total pump power for our system is 31.5 horsepower. So we go back to our original problem statement, which asks us to determine the power added by the pump. And we could safely say that we've calculated that in this problem.